have blood drawn, you ever go to the doctor's office? Right here in the middle, yeah, somewhere on your arm, right? We can ask for voluntary blood samples from our dolphins as well, but it doesn't come from their arm. Instead, it comes from the part of his body he's using to walk on water right now. Anyone want to shout it out? What do you think is the most important body for that behavior you just saw?
Fin.
His fin, his fluke, his tail. Exactly. A dolphin's tail is probably the most powerful part of their body. There's really, really strong muscles there. And if you look at their tail flukes, they have very, very big veins close to the surface. So what we can ask Spinnaker to do is show us his tail, not out of the water like we can sometimes see, but instead he'll actually present his tail to us at the dock, and just using that actually pretty small part of his body, if you look, we can get a voluntary blood sample from him to see that he's got everything going on inside his body he should, just as we can when we look at the outside for those regular husbandry behaviors. Now, of course, all of this healthcare and husbandry is great, but it's not the only part of training we do. When you come to the doctor's office, your doctor probably tells you that you need to do more to keep yourself healthy than just come to the doctor every year. Probably most of us have had our doctors tell us you need to eat a little bit better, right? I know I have. And also do some exercise too. And that's a whole other part of our training at the aquarium. Again, to make sure that Spinnaker gets that best care possible, we also ask him to exercise. All of those incredible behaviors we've seen where he's leaping out of the water, swimming pretty fast, moving his body. These are ways for us to make sure he's getting his daily exercise. Just like when you run on a treadmill, it takes a lot of energy for a dolphin to swim around the habitat here, but we ask him to do it to make sure that he's getting rid of all that excess energy that dolphins tend to have, because they are naturally very acrobatic animals. And Spinnaker in particular is a very unique species of dolphin. Has anyone ever seen a dolphin that looks like Spinnaker, actually, now that you're getting a good look at his body? Not too many people. I didn't expect you to, because Spinnaker is a Pacific white-sided dolphin. And that is a very unique species to find in facilities, but it's actually a species of dolphin you can find right here in British Columbia. If you've been lucky enough to take a ferry over to Nanaimo this summer, we're seeing more and more Pacific white-sided dolphins like Spinnaker playing around on the front of the ferries. Not usually with soccer balls, but definitely chasing down the front of the ferry in what we call bow riding. And as a Pacific white-sided dolphin, Spinnaker also tends to be one of the most acrobatic species of dolphins out there in the ocean. So they definitely have a lot of excess energy, and we want to make sure that he's getting the exercise he needs to use all that energy. But as a dolphin, Spinnaker is also incredibly intelligent. There's no secret that dolphins do have very big brains, and they're very intelligent, curious animals. So a whole other part of keeping Spinnaker healthy is making sure we're exercising his mind too. And as long as he's been with us at the aquarium, he's constantly learning new things to make sure that he's getting the mental stimulation that he needs. One of the most amazing pieces of mental stimulation that Spinnaker has undergone in the last 2 years has actually been some research training we've been doing. Because in fact, Spinnaker isn't only a really cool animal to work with, he's also a very special animal to work with. He knows how dangerous the ocean can be because he was actually rescued from a fishing net. All three of the dolphins we work with at the aquarium, in fact, are rescued and rehabilitated animals. If you look very closely at what would be Spinnaker's armpit, where his flipper joins his body, you might actually be able to see some built-up scar tissue there from that fishing net. Now, unfortunately, Spinnaker was deemed non-releasable. He can't survive on his own in the ocean anymore. But instead, he's here at the aquarium to act as an ambassador for his species. And for the last 2 years, he has been helping in a pretty amazing research project to try and figure out why dolphins get entangled in fishing nets in the first place, and what we can do to try and protect them from those nets out in the ocean. But we're only able to do this type of research and also all of that health care that Spinnaker undergoes because of people like you. The Vancouver Aquarium is a non-profit organization, so all the money that you paid to come in our doors today to watch Spinnaker and all of the other animals you see around here, all of that money goes directly back into our research and conservation efforts, and it helps us care for our dolphins. So on behalf of myself, our trainers, and of course, Spinnaker, our beautiful Pacific white-sided dolphin here, I'd like to thank all of you for joining us this morning, and also personally for helping us care for Spinnaker, the Pacific white-sided dolphin. Thank you very much, and have a great day at the aquarium.